Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on the subject Gas Dynamics and Jet Propulsion. This is lecture number 6. The topic is Isentropic Flow in Nozzle and Diffuser, Part 2. We recap from the earlier lecture. So in the previous lecture also, we discussed the isentropic flow through variable area duct. The variable area duct, there are two types of duct, one is nozzle, another one is diffuser. In the earlier lecture, we discussed the relationship between various properties in the isentropic flow through variable area duct. And in this lecture, we will be discussing the effect of variation, area variation in nozzle and diffuser. The learning outcome, at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to explain the shape of the nozzle diffuser in terms of area and Mach number. Effect of area variation. What is the effect of area variation in the isentropic flow? So we take a variable area duct and we take a small control volume of thickness dx in the direction of the flow. On the left side, before entry to the control volume, the area is A, pressure is P, rho is the density and T is the temperature. And after the control volume, the properties are A plus dA, there is change in the area, P plus dP, dP is the change in the pressure, rho plus d rho, the change in the density d rho, and T plus dT, dT is the change in the temperature. So the properties are changing across the small elemental control volume. And from the continuity equation, so in the earlier lecture, we discussed the continuity equation. Rho AC equal to constant. The mass flow rate is constant through the device, through the variable area. So the continuity equation is rho AC equal to constant. Differentiate this equation. So there are three variables, rho AC. So differentiating AC d rho plus rho C dA plus rho A dC. So when you differentiate one parameter, other two parameters are constant. Equal to 0 on the right hand side because differentiating constant becomes 0. Then divide the entire equation by rho AC. So when divide the entire equation, it becomes d rho by rho plus dA by A plus dC by C equal to 0. And this is the differential form of the continuity equation. So this we call it as equation number 1. Now the stagnation enthalpy equation. So stagnation enthalpy is equal to static enthalpy plus C square by 2. So, C square by 2 is the enthalpy due to the velocity. So, the H static enthalpy plus C square by 2 equal to stagnation enthalpy. Differentiate this equation with respect to differentiate along the duct. So, stagnation enthalpy is constant in the duct. So, for isentropic flow, stagnation enthalpy is constant. So, differentiate this equation H dH plus C square by 2. Differentiate it becomes C dC equal to 0 because HO is the constant in the isentropic flow. So this we call it as equation number 2. Then we have the thermodynamics. From thermodynamics we have H equal to U plus PV. So H is the enthalpy, U is the internal energy, P into V is the product of pressure and volume, which is called as flow energy. And differentiate this equation dH equal to dU plus PdV plus VdP. From first law of thermodynamics we have dH equal to del Q plus VdP. So, dH equal to del Q plus VdP because dU plus PdV equal to del Q. Del Q is the heat transfer. So, now for isentropic flow, there is no heat transfer. Del Q equal to 0 and this equation dH will become dP by rho. So, because specific volume V equal to small v equal to 1 by rho. So, dH equal to dP by rho. Then substituting in the equation 2. So, this equation, this we have to substitute in the previous equation. So, dC equal to minus dP by rho C square. This is equation number 3. Now, you substitute the equation number 3 in equation number 1. So, this become d rho by rho plus dA by A minus dC by C. So, dC by C, substituting for dC, this become minus dP by rho C square equal to 0. So, from this equation, we write dA by A equal to dP by rho C square minus d rho by rho. So, dA by A is the area change with respect to area, dP by rho C square minus d rho by rho. The density change divided by the density of the fluid. Now dA by A equal to, we take dP by rho C square as a common term. So dP by rho C square into 1 minus dP by d rho by dP into C square. Now we define the acoustic velocity, velocity of sound, A square equal to dP by rho. This also we defined earlier in the beginning lecture. Now we substitute for A square equal to dP by d rho. So this become dA by A equal to dP by rho C square into 1 minus C square. So dP, take the denominator, it becomes C square by A square. And again, C square by A square equal to M square. M is the Mach number. Mach number equal to C by A, velocity of sound divided by the velocity of sound in the air. So dP by A equal, dA by A equal to dP by rho C square into 1 minus M square. Or this is also we can write as dA by A equal to minus of dP by rho C square into M square minus 1. And substituting from the equation 3, this becomes dA by A equal to M square minus 1 into dC by C. Now we have two equations. One is dA by A equal to minus dP by rho C square into M square minus 1 and dA by A equal to M square minus 1 into dC by C. Now these are all the two equations. dA by A equal to dP by rho C square 1 minus M square or dA by A equal to M square minus 1 into dC by C. Now this, based on this expression, we will see what will happen when there is change in the area, change in the pressure and change in the velocity and change in the Mach number. So area change that we are going to determine, on the right hand side we have the variable like dP, Mach number, dC. So when the velocity, Mach number and pressure changes, what will happen to the area, what will be the change in the area, that is what we are going to observe. And I said there are two types of devices, variable area duct. One is nozzle. So nozzle, the purpose of the nozzle, increasing the velocity. So increasing the velocity at the expense of pressure. So by decreasing the pressure, velocity is increasing in the direction of the flow in the case of nozzle. So velocity increases. So DC is positive. DC is, change in velocity is positive and pressure decreases. dP is negative. The change in pressure is negative because the pressure is decreases. dC, change in velocity is positive because it is increasing in the direction of the flow. Now we take three cases. Mach number less than 1, which is called as subsonic flow. Mach number equal to 1, which is called as sonic flow. Mach number is greater than 1, which is called as supersonic flow. The second column, 1 minus m square. So when m is less than 1, 1 minus m square is positive and here it is 0 and when m is greater than 1, 1 minus m square is negative. When 1 minus m square is positive, m square minus 1 is negative and similarly 0 here and here it is positive. Now look at this equation. What is dA? You take the second equation, dA by A, m square minus 1 is negative. So this term is negative. dC is positive. dC is positive. So dC by C is positive, m square minus 1 is negative. So dA by A is negative. Negative means it decreases. Area decreases. When the area decreases, the passage is called as convergent. The shape is called as convergent. So this is what the convergent nozzle. So for convergent nozzle, so velocity increasing, pressure decreasing in the direction of the flow. For converging nozzle, so the Mach number is less than 1. Mach number is less than 1, it acts as a nozzle. It acts as a nozzle, so velocity increases, pressure decreases. And we take m is greater than 1. When m is greater than 1, this is called a supersonic flow. M square minus 1 is positive. So m square minus 1 is, this m square minus 1 is positive and dC is positive. So dA by A is positive. So when dA by A is positive, right, it increases. Positive means the area increases and this is called as divergent passage. So in the nozzle, when you have supersonic flow, at the entrance when you have supersonic flow, right, it is a divergent passage. So velocity increases, pressure decreases. So this is called as divergent passage, divergent nozzle. Now we have m equal to 1, so there is no change in the area, so this is called as throat section. So the first nozzle is convergent nozzle, second nozzle is divergent nozzle and third nozzle convergent divergent nozzle. So the first, initially it is converging nozzle and the Mach number equal to, Mach number is less than 1 for converging passage at the throat section Mach number equal to 1, and in the diverging passage Mach number is greater than 1. Now practically we are using only two types of nozzle. One is converging nozzle, another one is converging diverging nozzle. So at the entrance of the nozzle always the flow is subsonic. Practically So depending on the outlet velocity, depending on the outlet Mach number, we select either the converging nozzle or converging diverging nozzle. Suppose if you want subsonic flow at the outlet of the nozzle, we are selecting the converging nozzle. Always remember, always velocity at the entrance will be low. Velocity is increasing. Always at the entrance of the nozzle, the flow is subsonic. When you want subsonic outlet, then we take the converging nozzle. When you want supersonic outlet, then we prefer converging diverging nozzle. So for high speed flow where a high velocity, high Mach number is greater than 1, then we prefer converging diverging nozzle. So we are using only two types of nozzle, converging nozzle and converging diverging nozzle. Simply is known as CD nozzle. C stands for convergent, D stands for divergent, CD nozzle. And there is another device called diffuser. So diffuser is just opposite to nozzle. So in the diffuser, velocity decreases, pressure increases. The purpose of the diffuser is to increase the pressure by decelerating the flow. So nozzle is accelerating the flow, increasing velocity. Diffuser is decelerating the flow. So DC is negative pressure. DC decreases, velocity decreases, and DP is positive, pressure increases in the direction of the flow. Again, we take the same analysis for the diffuser. Again, Mach number is less than 1 subsonic flow, Mach number equal to 1 sonic flow, Mach number is greater than 1 supersonic flow. 1 minus m square is positive, m square minus 1 is negative because m is less than 1. So here I got 0, and the m, when the supersonic flow, 1 minus m square is negative, m square minus 1 is positive. Now we take dA. So here you take this equation. Velocity, so m square minus 1 is negative. So this term is negative. DC is also negative. So negative into negative, that becomes positive. So dA is positive. That means area is increasing. The passage is called as divergent passage. So for subsonic diffuser, Mach number is less than 1. The passage is diverging. So this is what the diverging passage. Subsonic diffuser, Mach number is less than 1. So the pressure is increasing, velocity is decreasing. And we take the supersonic, Mach number is greater than 1, then m square minus 1 is positive. So m square minus 1 is positive, DC is negative. So DC is negative, negative into positive equal to negative. So negative, that means Mach area is negative. DA is negative means area is decreasing. So area is decreasing, it is a converging passage. So it is converging shape, Mach number is greater than 1. So at the entrance, the flow is supersonic flow, and the, as the flow proceeds in the direction of the diffuser, the Mach number is decreasing, pressure increases, velocity decreases. Then we have the diverging converging diffuser. So this is again another type of diffuser where initially the flow is supersonic and finally it becomes subsonic. So the purpose of the diffuser is to reduce the velocity, decelerate the flow and increase the pressure. The purpose of the nozzle is decreasing the pressure and increasing the kinetic energy. So these two are the very important devices in the aircraft application, rocket application. So that is why we have to be very clearly understand the purpose of the nozzle and purpose of the diffuser. So in the diffuser, normally we are preferring the first one, diverging passage. Mach number is less than 1, right? So we stop here. So these are all the books I published in mechanical engineering subject. You may find your book, Gas Dynamics and Jet Propulsion. You can refer to the book for additional information on the subject. I upload the video lectures of all the subject in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel, use the video lectures for your better preparation. And thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. You can contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification on the subject. We'll meet again in another video lecture on gas dynamics and jet propulsion. Until then, bye.